What a difference a printout can make, Joe. As you were saying, a lot of flips in that last printout. We were talking before that printout about the Kauai County Council, where we thought so many incumbents were losing their seats. When we go down the 7, turns out many more kept their seats. A couple of incumbents lost their seats on Kauai. So it didn't turn out to be the proxy vote for Kauai's GMO ban that we thought it was. Now, the rest of the story also tonight on the GMO ban on Maui is that it's probably just the beginning. On Kauai, that law was their regulation was invalidated already by a federal judge. On the Big Island, they have a ban that had passed. That too is being tied up in court, and you can imagine that the same is likely going to be challenged here on Maui. We're trying to get a report now of how many, if any, uncounted votes there are on Maui. Would be a trickle, if anything, all of the across the islands. This final report includes everything except one card being driven in from Eva and a handful of any last-minute handed-in absentee votes that people decided to carry into the ballot box today. It's probably not going to be enough to make or break any of those different races. Something that really jumps out, though, tonight, take a look at this. Our calculations on voter turnout, we had nearly 62% in the last general, plummeted to 48%. Where was everybody this time? Also a big turnaround, people who voted early. You know, even just a few months ago in the primary, it was the first time that more than half of people had voted early. Now we're back to less than half of people voting early. So we know a lot of people did wait till today to make their decisions on these important issues, and it made a difference in things like the Maui GMO ban and other things. Joe, back to you.